Hello for Thursday, June 30th, and we enjoyed some more window dressing. Lower volume, the Dow moved up almost to the trend line, maybe even touched it, and above the 50% retrace. That's from the going from the March low to the high we got in, at the turn of May, April to May, and the first time above the 50-day all month. And it's been the first day of the month is that's when it dropped down here, and we've been down ever since, and we're back up above it. But up at that top Bollinger Band, so a little caution on that. And because the volume wasn't ripe, we'll see if banks or anything else can outmove it. But some bank, we'll get into that in a little while. Let's look at the futures chart of the Dow here, and we posted this, of course, in the midnight video, and then several times, and at the close also. We did a little 5-minute video on just some of the futures. Anyway, you had known on the overnight it ran up indeed to the 61.8 projection. This is based from, this is the zero line right there going across. That was the ladder breakout, and it ran up to it, and also this trend line, which goes back quite a while. So a pullback here would be logical. We did break below the RSI 70 line and came down. Now sometimes they can just get back up and go, but I don't think it's a good trade here myself. We showed in the other video what the projection is from that. I didn't do that in the screen capture, but you can look at that video we posted right after the close. But I like it better when we aren't going to these extremes like this, when we have a better setup to sit on your hands in between, or short when we have some trend line break. But at the moment, it's I don't think it's the greatest of trades, because it's not confirmed with volume or with other things. And here we've got the Russell. You can see, of course, it's a weekly. It's back inside, as you know. But this gives you an overview look here of the kind of progress we've made from breaking above that 809 high going up to the 822. So that's another nice move of just from the break of that level, another 12 points. So that's 1,200 points per contract if you trade the futures. Now, we've got also a Russell, I believe, Russell futures to show that one. And this one also, it ran above the 161. Now, this is not the higher level here. Actually, we did have that too. This is the, I can't seem to get my mouse over here. Here we go. So it's not from this level. It's from this lower level. It ran above this lower level, is 161, and basically from this level just about up to it. But above the trend line, that's the main thing. And then it broke down and it closed right at it. This is another one. I think it's run too much. And it's not a weak chart at the moment. I'm just not comfortable with it like we were before on the pullbacks down here. But at this level, I would like to see some consolidation first. Just my opinion. Okay, and SPX is the weekly. So you can see on the weekly, once again, we're back to this level, almost up to that trend line. We said we have to get above the 20-week moving average, 1316. That's what that is. And then a little bit higher to get back in good graces with that trend line. Here's another view. This is that same one that we broke up before, and we said, let's leave it. Sure enough, it did break out above that and above the 34-day moving average. So that's an important move. And maybe it'll just keep on going higher from here, or go sideways first would be our recommended mode if it could do that first. And I think we have a last chart of that also, just showing the on the 60-minute chart, the break above there. We have a futures chart of the S&P 500 showing that it ran to its, now it's based on its, I can move it over, I suppose. You bet you've seen these before, but here it's based on this breakout right there. Right there, that high, so that blue line is where the Fib projection is from. And so the 127%, it did that. And this next 127% is just from the low of the morning going back up to that high. So this is the overnight. Possible if you move an overnight on the upside, 1307 to look for, and 1311 would be the 161 based on that short-term projection. We'll show a couple other charts. I think we have, well, for instance, we've got this one, which is the oil, crude oil. And crude oil, when we did a video earlier in the day, it was just breaking out, and of course it's been trading within this channel for quite some time. It went down to the 161 projection on the downside, or almost to it, and started to move back up. And you can see it broke out basically above its 38% and then went to the same level as it was before. and it started to pull back. But this was a valid buy, a breakout from this trading channel, and now it could run. Maybe it stopped here to like a little double top, but if it breaks above the 95, we could, the 127 projection from this level, from this breakout level of 96.67, is 97.24. That also puts it up against the trend line that it broke through the last time. That's going to be strong resistance, and it's also an overall 61% retrace from the bigger move down. Okay, gold. I thought I had a silver here, but I don't. Anyway, silver was up a bit, bounced up, but it did not change the chart. Gold, as you see, was up a little bit. And intraday, there was a second green box on here, which would have made it a long. And we said it's whipsaw time again. We posted the chart showing that extra box and said this is not official till end of day, because we have that sometimes where, you know, people rush into some gold stocks and then GDX goes up and they get into it. But anyway, it's at the moment, all this time here until we break some kind of range, it's going to be some whipsaws. You don't have to use the system all the time. Once the trend is a little clearer, then you can get in it. SLV has stayed on the negative side as well. Some other things of interest were, you know, near the close, there was the announcement about the resolution, I guess, you have to read about it, of the what's going to happen with the banks insofar as what they can charge for these credit swipe fees when they swipe your card and so forth. And I think just because there's some word about that, you can see the big moves up in MasterCard. All of a sudden it took off and ran up 11%. And so did Visa as well, pretty much a similar situation, running up 15%. Though both of those you can watch on pullbacks because they might be fun trades depending on what they do. So pointing them out because of that. Meanwhile, the banking sector did not too much. It was up a couple of percent for the day, and it is good that we have positive RSI now. We broke above the MACD. I can show you that, I think. Here, that's crossed over, broke above. We have a positive histogram as well, and Williams is up. But you can see the trend line that we're running into. We're running into a broken trend line, and if it goes just into July a little bit next week, we're also running into the downtrend line. And so both of those are going to be important resistance area that it's got to overcome if it wants to, you know, move up anyway. Okay, so far as what some stocks were today, we had a good move on, just waiting for it to come up. Renren, and this one really liked the setup for a couple reasons. One, it was below the 20-day, which isn't as good, but the point is that it became a good target that everyone pays attention to the 20-day. And the volume has started picking up 2 days prior to the Wednesday. The other thing is a lot of IPOs that had pulled back severely had started to turn up, and there's been a lot of talk about that, you know, maybe it's time they found a level. Quite often with an IPO, since it has no history, they don't know what is the level, and it gets to a point, and then people decide, well, maybe that's it. So the trial is to boost it as high as they can and then fall again, and eventually they find a decent level. So we don't know how far this will go. 872 is the 20-day. If it breaks above that, it's got some room to run. Maybe it'll go up to the top Bollinger Band at 13. Maybe it's dead where it is here. But it did have increasing volume once again. If it breaks above the 20, it will probably get some more interest. Lava was one that triggered today and was okay for a while. And then by the close, look, it had lost that. But this does have a history of having some. See over here, it did the same thing. Has history of that, so when you see that as history of that, when you've got some gains in there, you can lock them in, or if you don't like the chart, obviously. You don't need to trade IPI. This had actually triggered the day before. It was another one that just continued to its top level here, about 1225. It did some move. Same case with CNK. It hit the first level yesterday. I think we forgot to mention these, but this one hit the second level again, ran up to the top Bollinger Band, and TSN also triggered just briefly. This was low level the day before and then ran up to the medium level during the day. Okay, so now we'll get to additions to the watch list. I do see that I have an SLV. What is we have here? Oh, that was that. Okay, so now we'll get to these if I can find them. Here we go. So what additions we have? We've got a couple that are, someone sent a tweet about this one. What do you think? And I looked at it. I thought, you know, it broke above this trend line, this downtrend line at one, you know, in the past. Then it went sideways and it had a good move up on encouraging volume. Then it had big volume when it came, sold off. Anyway, it's been dropping on much lower volume. So watch MOTR for a possible move up over that that bull, which probably will be a bull flag. And that would be probably around the 860 area. Here's the 850 right about where it is. You really have to watch it because we don't know what day. And this flag is going down. And it's not a perfect flag. If you see a good volume run rate and it starts moving and gets to, like, say, 850, maybe 840 at the time. If it's a good run rate, and particularly if it can break out of a bear flag, a bull flag, then it may run up to the 888 and even be an additional buy from there. Anyway, one to watch. Those kind are good. They don't always work, but when they do work, you know, they can have nice 10-12% moves. Now, ZAGG had been talked about a lot. It had some good movement up, and so we looked up and saw where this high was there. So if it can move, chain turn back around and move back up 1555, it's probably a long from there. It gives you at least that 30 cents to play with to even test its recent high. On the downside, if it's overplayed its hand, it may be under 1350 because of the high volume after it moved up nicely. Now remember that high volume, most of it was buying earlier and then when it sold off. So under the 1350, it may be a short. 1320 was low and then 13 was as well. But if you're interested in that, we pointed out for you. JRJC was another one that someone asked about. And, you know, the Chinese stocks, had a lot of them had problems and dropped. And this one, it sold off during the day and it moved up. But it ended up earlier, this was a red candle, turned out to be a green okay. I think if it can move back above that 343 level, it might be in play again. The volume did increase. RSI has already gone over. Williams has not. It's at 84. We want to get it up above 80, which would mean, you know, these numbers go the opposite of some numbers. It's minus, so you want it above minus 80, like 79, 78, so forth. Anyway, so watch this one, because if this moves up, then we got 372 as a 20-day and into this small little gap. C or OMX is a possibility over about 790. We've got a move there from the 790 possibly to 874. That's also the 50-day moving average. So we have 854 and then 874 on a move after 790. Excuse me. How about TIVO? Over $10.70. That's where we have the first line, and then the first line actually a little lower than 1070. Then 1080 would be the next level up, or 1088 where its little high was. So you can look left and see. But that also, it had increase in volume. You can't see it much because it's distorted with these huge 50 million share days. But it still had good volume at 4.4 million. So if it can get back up, we want to get it out of this range. There's too much congestion here. If we can break out of there, we could get some movement in it. And MS, oh, this one, over about 2350. It's not exact. What was its high of the day? 2344. But it looks like it's at this trend line, and we like the increased volume of it. So if it can keep on going above that, then 2389 is a 50-day, and if that gets cleared, then we can maybe get going. And another one we'll just mention, it's not officially on the watch list as yet, and that is just Baidu. I'm not sure that I like all this congestion over there, and I don't like the fact that the volume hasn't increased much, but that is a possibility. So that's enough for Thursday. I hope you have a great trading day. We'll send out tweets during the day on Thursday. And, of course, be back tomorrow night with some new additions to the watch list in Market Wrap. And so I think we'll leave you tonight with a little bit of music it's called Whisperlude. Anyway, we'll have more on this in another day in the future. So thanks a lot. Have a great night and a good day trading on Thursday as well. We'll see if we can.